All right, well, as y'all may have noticed, I have not put out very many videos lately. I have been busy recently doing work at this place mostly. I got two or three big projects going here that have been eating up all my time and robbing me of my creative abilities. But right up there is where we're going to be here in a second. And finishing up, we've been working on that for the last couple of days. And down there on that other end where the new construction is for several days. So I've got just some little clips and all. Basically, I'll just kind of show you what I've been up to so you won't think I've been laying around slacking and living the good life. Actually been working and trying to accomplish something. On top of everything, preparedness wise too. So anyway, we'll take you up there and show you what's going on. Yesterday was a hard day. I'm getting too old to work like this. Hey, Eddie. Eddie's the welder. Kind of the head muckety muck of this project, if you want to call it that. My piece of conduit's gone. I guess my helper is all over it. Yep, there he is. He's hauling the bucket up now. So here we go. Lots of good exercise in this job for sure. Did you grab that piece of conduit?
Yeah.
Thank you. I was looking for it. Seems darker in here than it did yesterday.
Different tools I've got here. I've got an ascender. A lot of people call it a fumar, but this is a pencil. It allows the rope to slide one direction because it's got these teeth on it right there. Then when you lock it in place, the rope won't slide out, but it will slide back. And then it toggles it into place. And so it's used for climbing. That's why it's called an ascender. The descender, it's just a simple figure eight descender ring right here, which is easy enough to use. Anybody that's into climbing already knows this stuff, but basically, you double up your rope, poke it through the big end, loop it over the small end. Clip it on and you're ready to go. And you can let yourself down nice and slow. I've been using this setup here about 40 years. Still in good shape. What a mess, but it works. Thank you. never a dull moment. Okay, send the bucket back down.
Video this, and then later on we can go back over it and examine all the parts you got wrong. I'm kidding. Jared never gets anything wrong. Well, never might be a
almost.
Only almost, exactly. See what Eddie and the welders are getting wrong. Actually, they're not getting anything wrong. They're getting a couple extra steps in there. That's going to make it much nicer. Today's a nice day. It's still not terribly windy. A little bit of a breeze probably show up on the camera, but it isn't near bad. Hang on. I'm in a bad spot. Okay. Good. We still could have made it work, but it would have been aggravating. Yeah, that's gonna be just right. What we're doing, in case everybody's wondering, we're running conduit over here so that we can get wire up to this big motor here that runs this leg. All right, there we go. Now we're gonna put a couple of straps on it and we'll be good.
Jared, I think we're gonna call it good and we're done for the day. What do you think about that?
Sounds pretty good.
Yes, it does sound pretty stinking good. I'm ready. It is Miller time or Long Star time or something time. I'm glad it's not full-blown summertime. It gets hot up here. I mean, way hot.
Yeah.
All right. Thank you, Jared. So a couple of y'all have seen this before. I know Wes has seen this fertilizer plant. Ooh, that cool air feels good. And we don't need to take this conduit home with us. We can do this without getting full in the sunshine. Oops, sorry, that bumped into me. I'm clumsy in my old age. Isn't that funny? I don't remember the wind blowing up there this much. So, that's it. So you can see it goes into that machine right there. With the auger spinning, and it busts up the chunks and keeps those thick ones from getting in there that might jam it up. Then it goes into that blender right there, mixes it up a little bit, and then up the conveyor and into the truck. That red number's on the scale. It tells how much is in there so they know how much they're putting in the truck so they don't overload it.
process of raising food for the country, or in this case, maybe raising cotton. It depends on who kicks this bat. Big trucks are divided into two bins, and when the one gets full, they pull forward and it can fill up the second one.